Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Accountancy for Sure. Today we will discuss partnership accounts fundamentals, salary or commission to partner from T.S. Grewal, page number 2.84, question number 31 onwards. The question says, Amar, Bhanu and Charu are partners in a firm. Amar and Bhanu are to get an annual salary of ₹1,20,000 per annum each as they manage the business. Net profit for the year is ₹4,80,000. Determine the share of profit to be credited to each partner. So to solve this, our net profit for the year is ₹4,80,000. From this we will subtract salary to partners. Amar and Bhanu. Both are getting an annual salary of ₹1,20,000. So 2,40,000. Now remaining is also 2,40,000. This is divisible profit. Now this divisible profit will be divided among the partners in their profit sharing ratio. And there is no profit sharing ratio suggested in the question. So they all will get equally. 1:1:1. So Amar will get 2,40,000 into 1/3. Bhanu will also get 2,40,000 into 1/3, that is equal to ₹80,000. Here also rupees. And Charu will also get from 2,40,000 his 1/3 share, that is equal to ₹80,000. Now this question can also be shown in profit and loss appropriation account, but the question says that determine the share of profits. So this way we can also determine the share of profit, because nothing is written about whether we have to prepare profit and loss appropriation account or not. So this way also it can be solved. Now next question, question number 32 from T.S. Grewal. It says that A, B and C are partners in the ratio 2:2:1 and net profit for the year is ₹1,10,000. And A will get a commission. A's commission is equal to 10% of net profit. So which will be equal to 1,10,000 into 10 divided by 100. So A will get a commission of ₹11,000. Very simple to calculate. Now let us see the next question. Question number 33. There are three partners A, B and C and they share profits and loss equally. And Z is entitled to commission. Z's commission is equal to 10% of net profit after charging such commission. And net profit given in the question is ₹2,20,000. It means net profit is equal to Z's commission plus divisible profit. It means Z will get 10% of this divisible profit. If divisible profit is 100%, then Z will get a commission of 10% of the divisible profit. It means net profit is 110% of divisible profit. Net profit is equal to 110% of divisible profit. So what will be the divisible profit? So divisible profit is equal to net profit into 100 divided by 110. What we want? Divisible profit. Divisible profit is 100%, so we are multiplying net profit with 100%. And how much is net profit? Net profit is 110%, so it will be divided by 110. What we want will be multiplied, and what it is will be divided. So here we will get 220,000 multiplied by 100 divided by 110. In this case, we will get rupees 2 lakh. Now, Z's commission. Is equal to divisible profit into 10%, which is equal to 2 lakh multiplied by 10 divided by 100, that is equal to rupees 20,000. This is our answer. Now our next question is question number 34 from the same book. It says that A, B, C and D are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio 4:3:2:1, and it earned a net profit of, net profit is also given, rupees 1,80,000 for the year ended 31st of March 2020. As per the partnership deed, they are to charge a commission of 20% of the net profit after charging such commission. Now commission is to be paid. Commission is equal to 20% of divisible profit. 20% of divisible profit. Here net profit is not the divisible profit. Divisible profit is the profit which is arrived after deducting commission from net profit. But we are knowing only net profit, so we have to deduct first the commission and then we have to arrive at divisible profit. So we can say that net profit is equal to commission plus divisible profit. It means if divisible profit is 100%, if we take divisible profit as 100%, commission has to be 20% of divisible profit. Therefore, net profit is how much? Net profit is 120% of divisible profit. So, divisible profit we can find out. Divisible profit is equal to net profit into 100 divided by 120. That is equal to 1,80,000 multiplied by 100 divided by 120. We will get rupees 1,50,000. Now commission is equal to is equal to 20% of divisible profit, which is 1,50,000. So it will be 20% of 1,50,000, which is equal to rupees 30,000. Now the question says that the commission will be paid to all the partners. Commission to A, B, C and D in a ratio 2:3:2:3. So this rupees 30,000 commission will be apportioned or distributed among the partners. This is commission. To A, B, C and D in 2:3:2:3. So A will get how much? 30,000 into 2 divided by 10, which is equal to rupees 6,000. B will get 30,000 into 3 divided by 10, which is equal to rupees 9,000. C will get 30,000 into 2 by 3, that is equal to again rupees 6,000. And D will get 30,000 into 3 by 10, it is 10. 3 by 10, which is equal to rupees 9,000. So total is 30,000 only. Now the question says you are required to show profit and loss appropriation account. So after calculating this much, we will draw a profit and loss appropriation account. Now this is profit and loss appropriation account in which we had a net profit of rupees 1,80,000. So we will apportion it to commission. To partners. A, B, C and D. We have distributed the commission in the ratio 2:3:2:3. So as we have calculated rupees 6,000, then rupees 9,000, then rupees 6,000 and then rupees 9,000. All together it is 30,000. And the remaining is the profit. It is divisible profit, which will be distributed as suggested in the question 4:3:2:1. So A, B, C and D will get the remaining profit, which is 1,50,000 will be 1,50,000 and both the sides total will be equal. Rupees 1,80,000 and now this 1,50,000 will be distributed in this ratio. So 1,50,000 into 4 by 10 we will get 60,000 for A, and then 1,50,000 into 3 by 10 will be 45,000 for B, and 1,50,000 into 2 by 10 that is equal to 30,000 for C, and 1,50,000 into 1 by 10 that is equal to 15,000 for D. Now we will solve the next question from T.S. Grewal, question number 35, page number 2.84. Now the question says X and Y are partners in a firm. X is entitled to a salary of rupees 10,000 per month and a commission of 10% of the net profit after partner's salary but before charging commission. And Y is entitled to a salary of rupees 25,000 per annum and a commission of 10% of the net profit after charging all commission and partner's salaries. Net profit before providing for partner's salaries and commission for the year ended 31st of March 2019 was rupees 4,20,000. Show distribution of profit. So here we are having net profit. By net profit transferred from profit and loss account is 4,20,000, and salary we have to give to partners. To partners salary to partner X and partner Y. It says that X is entitled to a salary of 10,000 rupees per month. So 10,000 into 12 will be rupees 1,20,000, and Y will get a salary of rupees 25,000 per annum. So salary together is 1,45,000. Then we have to pay commission. So 2x commission. Now X commission is 10% of the net profit after charging partner's salary. So from 4,20,000, if salary is deducted, from this profit, this remaining profit, X is to receive a commission of 10%. It will be rupees 2,75,000 10%, which is equal to rupees 27,500. Now, but to Y's commission, it says that commission of 10% of the net profit after charging salary and all the commissions. It means that both the commissions we have to subtract and salary also we have to subtract from net profit. So how will Y receive? Y will receive a commission of 2,75,000, this one, because it is already from net profit we have subtracted salary, and from this salary we have to subtract the first commission minus 27,500, and this is also 10%, so into 10 divided by 110, because both the salaries we have to subtract. This is the first salary and Y's this is the first commission and Y's commission also we have to subtract. So in that way it is 10 divided by 110. How? I will show it here. Remaining profit. After salary and commission. Commission. Is equal to net profit minus salary minus X commission minus Y's commission. This will be our remaining profit. So it will be net profit is how much? 4,20,000. Minus salary is 1,45,000 minus 27,500 minus Y's commission. This is our remaining salary. It means from this we can say that remaining salary which can also be said as divisible profit not salary it is remaining profit divisible profit is equal to 2,47,500 minus Y's commission. Now Y's commission is 10% of divisible profit. So if divisible profit is 100%, then Y's commission has to be how much? 10%. And this 2,47,500 is how much? This 2,47,500 is actually 110% of divisible profit. So divisible profit is equal to 247,500 into 100, this is divisible profit into 100, divided by this 247,500 is 110%, so divided by 110, we will get 225,000. Now, why's commission? Is equal to 225,000 10%, which is equal to 22,500. So we will write here 22,500. Now comes the profit, that is the divisible profit, and no profit sharing ratio is suggested in the question, so it will be distributed equally. ₹2,25,000 is our divisible profit. This will be divided by 2 and either we'll get, see, 2,25,000 into 1 by 2 is equal to 1,12,500. Same is the case with Y, is 2,25,000 into 1 by 2, that is the other half, that is also equal. Grand total is 4,20,000. Here also 4,20,000. This is the answer. Thank you so much for watching my channel.